students who've appeared for NEET this year have raised questions over several aspects about the exam that was conducted. Particularly one was that there were 67 students who scored a complete score of 720, having an AIR rank 1, which had raised several questions. In fact, the questions were also raised because of 67 students, 8 of them were from the same center at Patna. Now, particularly in Maharashtra, there have been several parents who've gone and met the Minister Hassan Mushrif, asking to take a stance on this. In fact, Hassan Mushrif has also stated that there's a possibility that there could have been some discrepancies in the exam, there could have been a fraud that could have been conducted, and they are in the process of speaking to the central authority, central government, to ensure some stance is taken on this NEET exam. Apart from that, there have been two pleas that have been filed at various courts across the country, particularly at Delhi High Court. They've asked the NTA to put their stance forth. We have some students and parents here at Thane with us. Some of these students have appeared for the NEET this year. We try to speak to them. Some of the parents are also doctors themselves. We try to speak to them and understand what is the stance and what is it that they're going to speak to the government about. So thank you for speaking to us. We've seen you all have raised questions. You all have said that there has to be a protest that has to take place when it comes to the exam results this time. What exactly is it that you all are putting forth in your protest?
Yes. First of all, let me tell you, there is so much of uproar. Why the NTA is giving a deaf ear? Why they cannot listen to the plight of the thousands and millions of students all over there? There is no explanation has been given by the NTA. The thing is that itself, the result was declared. The result was supposed to be come by 15th of June. And all of a sudden, the result is declared on a day when there is a election, general election result for June. Means they are trying to hide something. And there were news about the paper leak also. All the major media has covered all this leak news. And even few of the parents and the students were also arrested in Patna and Bihar and all over there. Means there is a definite paper leak, and that has caused a drastic change in the merit this time. The thing is that I will give few examples. Usually a merit increases by just 4 to 5 years every year. See, I'm a doctor, I'm into this field for last 30 years. Since my days, I know the merit usually goes by 4 or 5 marks. This year something drastic has happened. And still NTA is not giving the heed. When there was lot of uproar, then NTA came and then said, we given grace mark. It's a big question mark. In such competitive examination, grace mark has been never given. And what kind of grace mark is given? And why the NTA has not declared before the result that they are going to give the grace mark? And because of this grace mark, I think the merit has gone haywire. For example, last time in Maharashtra, students were getting medical admission in a government medical college for 570. This year, they are not getting even 80 marks higher to this merit. So where these students will go? The other thing is that from a small center like Jhajjar in Haryana, 8 students have scored 720 out of 720. This never happens. Scoring a 720 like once upon a lifetime opportunity. How can this happen from a one center? 10 students, 8 students are scoring 720 marks. I think 2-3 cases are filed in the court, and NTA is accountable. They should come out with proper explanation, and they should now take the corrective measures. Lakhs and lakhs of students are suffering because of that.
You're a student yourself. Yeah. I would want to understand from you, what was the marks you scored? What are you aspiring for? And has this any way hampered with your aims?
Actually, I scored 480, but I was expecting a marks of 520 or 530. There was an issue in an exam center, like they are whether coming again and again, they have signs and all, they could have done in one time also. Okay, I have also wasted my time. I had called them out and given a complaint, but they were like, this is not possible. This thing has not happened anywhere. So if they are getting grace marks, then I should also get a grace mark, obviously. And I should also deserve that marks. If I get that marks, I would also get a college. Right now, there's no hope for getting that because of this too much high cutoffs and all. So that's what I just want to say, that everyone is getting grace mark for that time thing, and then I also wanted that.
Ma'am, you're a parent. Could you tell me about what are the problems you're facing when it comes to your child, when it comes to this questions being raised over the NEET examination?
Yeah, so this year, obviously, the rank is drastically dropped. Last year, for the same number of marks, the rank was somewhere around 8,000. Now the rank is gone to 44,000. So there is a gap of around 30 to 35,000 students. So from where they have suddenly come? It is not that the talent is gone up. It is not that the number is gone up. And I want to stress on this point that the grace mark system is total flaw. what NTA is giving a clearance or their clarification is that they have applied some judgment in 2018, which was for the CLAT exam, and that exam was online. Plus, we searched the judgment. It says that it is excluding, it cannot be applied for medical and engineering college. So how can they take such a whimsical and random decision, that also keeping all the students in the dark? So this system is a total flaw. Grace marks should be scrapped, and the centers where unfair means have been taken, they should go for re-examination, or they should be barred from appearing or conducting such kind of competitive exams.
So, you know, in their defense, we've seen that NTA has said that there has been an increase in the number of students who've applied this year. There have been 23 lakh students who applied. Of course, like the grace mark aspect that's been mentioned, there have been several students who've been given grace mark. Questions are on the students who've gotten 718 and 719, because that's where the problem arises. As far as we understand from the parents, those who scored anywhere above 650 would get admission in government colleges. But now the question for these students who could get examination, could get admission in government colleges, still rises. We try to speak to one of the students. Tell us, where were you aspiring to get your admission? What is your score, and what are the problems that you're facing currently?
So I have scored 611. The students who were securing 611 last year had a chance, little bit chance for aspiring a government seat, but now due to the inflammation of ranks, we are not getting the government seat, and that's the main problem the students are facing now. And mental status of the students is not so good, because they were preparing from 2 to 3 years last year, and now it's not a big deal now for them to get the government seat in medical.
So why do you think this entire problem has arisen? Is it because there have been more students that are giving examination, or what's the problem?
No, more competition was increasing every year. The competition was increasing only, but the inflammation of ranks was the main reason for the students not appearing for the government seat. Yes.
So these are some of the parents. We'd also speak to one of the parents right here. Ma'am, tell us what is the problem you are facing?
Yeah. Every year there are almost 17 to 18 lakh students who are appearing for this NEET exam. I agreed there were this time 23 to 24 lakhs, but whatever the 8 lakh students who are extra, definitely not all of them were scholar. See, the ratio is like only 20-30% will be scholar, and whatever the rank or cutoff has to be increased, it's hardly by 300-400, say 10,000 ranks, not so much. See, my daughter with the score of 601 last year, on the same score, her score would have been 22,000 or something. Today she is on 80,000. There are 50,000 students who have come in between, and I don't think this is a fair game. I just want to ask two questions, and I want answer for that. It is, you don't have right to play with the kids' future, one thing. Second thing, see, a NEET is a very dignified exam, because you are going to give future doctors. Finally, you are resting the future of the country in the hands of the people who are going to appear for this exam. And NTA does not have right to play with the health and the future and society as per. Whatever the candidates you are fetching by this fishy business and all this fraud, you are not doing right, because you are finally putting 140 billion people, health and everything in the hands of the person who are going to carry a stethoscope and going to roam around with a dignified profession. So you really don't have any right to play with the lives of the people, giving them a doctor degree. There are two parts of injustice. Injustice on our part as a kids and as a parents, and injustice on the total nation part. So a strict action, I would appeal to Supreme Court to take a strict actions against such a fraud body who has been held responsible for all this nonsense what is happening today.
See, the inflation in the rank this year is mainly because of the grace mark. As madam told, few years back the grace marks was given for some online exam. You cannot compare online exams with the offline exam. If the patient had lost some time in an offline exam, you always had an alternative to give them the extra time, rather than giving them hundreds of marks as a grace marks in a competitive NEET exam. It is not acceptable. Even in the schoolings, you don't give 100 marks grace for a kid of 8th standard to promote into the 9th standard. It is not acceptable. The parents are told that let the student be in the 8th standard. In such a competitive exam, you are giving person scored 620, he's being given 100 marks extra, and thus he has come to 720 marks. And that is why there are 67 or 68 students who are scoring 720 on 720. It is not that they are deserving 720. And most of the kids have almost appeared for all the questions. Till they were given Grace Ma saying that in the center there was some delay in the giving some paper or something had gone wrong, which is not acceptable, I feel. So there should be justice to everybody. These grace marks which were given extra should be withdrawn and a fresh merit list has to be released by the NTA. NTA is hiding something. They are protecting some people. They are promoting some people for to get admissions into the medical college because of there some hidden agenda. Some type of things, corruption has gone wrong. They should take their decision of giving grace marks back and release the re-merit list.
So those were some of the parents and students we spoke to. In fact, the NEET examination is held to fill more than 1,08,000 seats across 700 institutions, to which in Maharashtra particularly we've heard the minister say that they will ask for a re-examination in this case. As of now, the decision is pending with various courts. We have to wait and watch as to what really happens when it comes to the future of these kids and their parents who've been, in fact, reaching out to various authorities, marking a protest against the examination that was held.